Hello everybody and welcome to today's lesson on solving by factoring. And today our objective will be, we will be able to solve a quadratic equation by factoring. Let's get started and let's first talk about what does it really mean to solve a quadratic equation. To solve a quadratic equation, we need to find certain x values. And those x values are the x values that make the equation become true. That says a x squared plus b x plus c is equal to zero. So when we set that quadratic equation equal to zero, we need to find the x values that make that equation true. When we look at the equation in standard form, it's not quite apparent yet which x values those would be. Now we can of course go ahead and plug in all sorts of numbers for x and see which ones of them will turn the left side of the equation to zero, and those will then be the values that make the equation become true. But it's way easier to do that when the equation is factored. Because when the equation is factored, we can use a certain property, and that's the zero product property, to find our x values. Then let's remember what the zero product property is. The zero product property states that if a times b is equal to zero, so that would be the product of a and b. If that product is zero, then either a has to be equal to zero or b has to be equal to zero, those being the two factors of that product. That means that if we have our quadratic equation in factored form, we only need to find the x values that make either one of the two factors turn to zero. Let's look at this example. If x plus 3 times x minus 5 is equal to zero, and x plus 3 is a factor and x minus 5 is a factor, then either the x plus 3 is 0 and turned the whole product to 0, or the x minus 5 is 0 and turns the whole product to 0. And those factors will give us the numbers that we need for x. They may be two different numbers and they won't turn both of the factors to zero at the same time, but that's not necessary. Each number will turn one of the factors to zero, and then the entire product turns to zero. With that being said, we're now ready to use factoring to find the solutions of a quadratic equation. First, of course, we need to factor the function completely, and then we're going to find the values for x that turn each of the factors to zero. And in order to find those solutions, we're going to look at the factors and we're going to follow three quick steps. We take the number out of the parentheses, we switch its sign, and then we divide by the coefficient of x, if there is a coefficient other than one. And this is a shortcut. You can, of course, do the same thing by solving an algebraic equation, which I'm going to show you too, but the shortcut works every single time. So let's look at our examples. X plus 3 times 2x minus 4. This is the factored form of a trinomial that we were given, and we need to use those factors now to find our solutions. So one of the solutions could be taking the number 3, switching the sign from positive to negative, and dividing by the coefficient of x. Now x has a coefficient of 1, so we don't have to divide much. This is negative 3 is one of our solutions. You can always take that number and plug it back into the parentheses and see if that's really true. Negative 3 plus 3 is 0, so yeah, that's it. And the other solution is x is equal to, take the number, negative 4, switch the sign, so we're going to make it positive, divide by the coefficient of x. Dividing by 2, so 4 divided by 2, That's two. And here are our two solutions. And as I said, the algebraic process behind this shortcut is taking the equation 2x minus 4 and stating that that has to be 0. So now how is that going to turn to 0? We're going to have to solve it for x. Add 4 on both sides. We get 2x is equal to 4. Then we divide both sides by 2, and x is equal to 2. And that gives us the same solution as our shortcut. Let's try the other example real quick. X minus 4 times 3x plus 7. So our first solution is going to be x has to be equal to negative 4. Take the number, switch the sign, which makes it positive. Divide by the coefficient of x, and the coefficient of x is 1, so we don't have to worry. The answer is x is equal to 4. 4 minus 4 is 0. And the other one, x is equal to, take the number, which is 7, switch the sign, make it negative, and divide by the coefficient of x, that's 3. So the solution is x is equal to negative 7/3. And if you plug that into the second parentheses, then you will also see that that'll turn those into 0. All right, you guys, that's really it. And here it all comes together. Finding the solutions of a quadratic equation means we're finding the values that will turn that equation to 0. In standard form, that's not that easy, but taking the equation in standard form, factoring it, and then finding the values for x that will turn either one of those two factors to 0 gives us the solution that we needed. All right, you guys, so much for this, and I will see you in class.